Hi, my name is Chris, I am CG artist. I am sure that every game developer has faced the difficulties when creating an interface. UI designer always want to make our UIs both original and beautiful. In this video I will show how to make the UI attractive and analyze it in practice. But first we'll talk about the interface in general terms. So let's start. The UI should always suit to a game well. Otherwise, it will push off the player and create discomfort for them. But making a good interface is quite a difficult task. Of course, you can pick up examples from other successful projects, their composition, accents, colors, proportions, but it is also important to understand why their design works. When creating a game, you need to determine what type of interface will be used. It can be flat and include simple flat icons with shading, highlights, shape lines. This style is very easy to edit and scale for different screen formats. Physical 3D consists of hand-drawn prominent shapes, or a proceeded 3D models with sophisticated elements and patterns. For example, I would use flat style for shooters, action, sci-fi, or games with minimalistic cartoon graphics, or in RPGs combining with volumetric icons. Medieval fantasy and card games will look well if the UI is made in physical style. Kingdom Come Deliverance or Diablo are good examples of it. It is important to remember that the interface must blend with the visual of the game well and maintain its style. Think of two completely different games. The Warcraft series with its heavy stone metal interface in a gothic dark style, conveying the atmosphere of the game, and Nier with a modern flat interface, sometimes breaking the first wall. Here the interface is part of your character. Hood or heads-up display is what you see during gameplay. Characters, health, mana, minimap. It is important to make the HUD organic and easy to read. Also, it should neither interfere with the player with its colorfulness, nor occupy most of the screen. Only clearly display important information. For example, when a character has low health, the edges of the screen may turn red, the health bar may blink or the screen may darken a little, symbolizing the character's imminent loss of consciousness. Information may also be displayed commonly through pop-up text as in MMO games. FE, fronted menus, are an inventory menu ability book bars. FE has to be user-friendly, intuitive, and its windows have to be easy to find. Also, do not forget that the player may have experience in other games of a similar genre and may expect a similar arrangement of windows and buttons in your game. There is no need to be afraid of repeating well-working interface schemes. We should not overload the interface. The more elements, the more difficult it will be to make the UI intuitive. Remember the right interface from any MMORPG. For a player unfamiliar with its genre, such abundance of elements can simply scare off. When creating HUD, do not use more than 7 elements. It is also desirable to place them at the edges of the screen. In this case, it will be easier to adjust the game for different monitor resolutions. When there is a lot of text in the game, replace them with pictures, icons, arrows. Too many elements become annoying, especially in games with a lot of action. A well-designed icons is better than any text. When creating FE, try not to make the windows on more than 3 levels. Also work with text, highlight headings, create paragraphs, use a readable font, but do not over-design. Otherwise, it will be easy for the player to confuse interactive elements with non-interactive ones. Let's move on to design and compositional techniques, directly to the creation of interface itself. In the video, I will be working with assets. Consider the proportions. A very simple and working method is to divide everything in ratio of 8 to 5 or 2 to 1. Such proportions affect the perception of objects well, since many objects in our world are built on this principle. It is also called the golden ratio and plays an important role in design, cinema, visual art, etc. Also, feel free to use symmetry and rhythm. Do not use acidic or conflicting colors. Use minimum of accent colors such as red, yellow, white, as they should be placed where you need to grab the viewer's attention. For example, usually the exit or action buttons are red. Play with contrasts in order to prevent the elements of the picture from merging into one. Use light objects on a dark background. Adding a shadow or glow around the subject alone works well. Glowing and blinking are probably the most effective attention-grabbing techniques, as well as combination of cool and warm colors. Do not stretch pictures. Use Photoshop or the engine's capabilities to scale images, or change their proportions. Otherwise, the composition will look badly and inharmonious. Do not mix assets of different styles in one work. If it is impossible, try to use assets made by one artist or studio. Look for assets that are of a very similar style and color of the one you're already using, or change the color of your elements in Photoshop. Use Photoshop or another graphic editor to assemble your interface. Create several variations and templates. Of course, there are ready-made PSD templates, but we'll also try to create something new. Now you can see how I start creating my interface. This is the character creation menu. Sometimes I start with simple sketches, but it is not necessary. It is best to put the background first, preferably from your game, so that is easier to choose the UI style, color schemes and adjust distance between the windows. Then I work from general to specific objects, add large background panels and starting from them create our interface. You can see on the screen that I have immediately put left and right panels. I also suggest using hotkeys in order to speed up the process of creating this interface. Combine icons with text. In the video you can see me trying to insert icons so that they look harmoniously. At the same time, I keep in mind where the action buttons will be. I also create nominal lines so that there is no chaos in interface. It is important to add here some rhythm. The next small unpleasant work is editing the text. It is necessary to come up with the size of the headings. Choose color of the text in order to prevent appearing of imbalance in my masterpiece. Then I highlight the buttons, which will be shown as selected by the player so that the active keys are immediately visible on the screen. I also used more neutral brown buttons, but I think a saturated red will work as well. Red blends with blue very well, although it is important that the blue will not be too bright. Here I will try to create two windows, a back and an inventory, using the Medieval Kingdom UI. Creation of these windows was inspired by one very popular RPG, I think you can guess which one. In general, there is nothing complicated, you just have to place the titles correctly and choose the right font. For the inner space, I use darkened border to make the icons look good on their background. I have also highlighted a back menu in order to show that it is now active. I think it is obvious the less cartoonish icons are suitable here. Since the interface style is close to realistic, unlike the previous example. In the inventory menu, I decide that it would be nice to place the character model in the middle and put flags on the sides. I have also repainted them in dark blue for a little diversity and placed icons with armor and weapons on them. At the bottom, I will place the characteristic window. As to me, such proportions look good, but I had to slightly scale the frame, but by no means do I stretch it. Since I have a little space left, I will add slots for the rings and necklace. I think it is a good idea to make them smaller than the rest of the armor. Some work with the text and you're done. We can move to the demonic UI and try to create the quest journal. Here I will not use references, but I will try to do something original by myself. To be honest, working without examples is difficult. It takes a lot more time, so I decided to rely on the composition rules and use the 5-to-8 rule. Due to lack of symmetry, I find it difficult to set the header, but I still don't like how it comes out. There are too many red buttons, what interferes with right perception of the scene, so I made the unselected items black. I have also decided to muffle the non-interactive text, that is, names of the tasks. I decided to color the text on the paper with a slight faded ink effect, using the dark brown color. Eventually, I decided that I should insert a picture of the location and add a little of blue color to my interface, which will make it more interesting, and the top panel will add a little atmosphere to the game. I have also decided to clean up the left window due to the blue lines. It seems to look quite well. What do you think? Write your opinion in the comments. And also like the video if it was useful for you. Thus you will let me know what it makes sense to do more. Bye everyone, thanks for watching.